Hello friends, how you doing today? We're back again with some latest space updates for you. Today we'll start with an update on Falcon Heavy launch, followed by an update regarding AST and SpaceX agreement will come first, as the Texas-based mobile broadband constellation startup SpaceMobile and SpaceX have a contract that allows for the possibility of scheduling Falcon 9 or Starship missions through the end of 2024. We'll end with an update on upcoming return of CRS-25. Let's get started with an update on SpaceX Falcon Heavy having a good chance to launch in 2022. Recently, the US Space Force announced that SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket could still carry out their first operational launch for the military in late 2022. We know that launch of Falcon Heavy is delayed from late 2020 to late 2021 and then early and mid-2022. SpaceX, in the meantime, has also bagged almost 11 Falcon Heavy contracts, and now the launch is shifting to late 2022. But still, in the face of delays, Space Force's statement comes with a ray of hope. According to Space Force, SpaceX's first operational Falcon Heavy launch for the US military could possibly be carried out sometime from October to December 2022. The agency also revealed that they'll now permit SpaceX to use flight-proven Falcon Heavy boosters on military launches, saving a good deal of money. Report says that if SpaceX follows this present launch timeline, then the fourth launch of Falcon Heavy will be carried out almost 40 months after its third launch back in 2019. With Space Force's new decision of using a flight-proven Falcon Heavy booster, the pains of delays can be avoided for quite a good deal. Sources state that the US military will preserve the rights to select or modify Falcon Heavy boosters for assigning it into any military missions. They'll also determine the sequence of flight-proven boosters for reusing in missions. The Space Force found that the recovery, refurbishment, and launch of SpaceX boosters utilizes well-established processes. Already, the US military has approved the use of flight-proven Falcon 9 boosters. Earlier, the agency had allowed SpaceX to fly two reused Falcon Heavy side boosters on the rocket's first test launch for the military STP-2 mission. Now, after winning certification from the Pentagon Space Force to use recyclable boosters, SpaceX will likely be able to plan future Falcon Heavy launches with a quick launch cadence. This decision will work out a much better way if the military is comfortable with reusing those Falcon Heavy boosters that have supported non-military launches. Todd Harrison, a space systems analyst with Meta Aerospace, said, "The certification to use previously flown side boosters further supports the alternative business model SpaceX has used to break into the space launch market. I think this certification is an implicit endorsement of SpaceX's approach to innovation." In our next update, let's start with the Starship contract. First satellite launch order has been placed for SpaceX's Starship rocket of the next generation. With the help of their next-generation transportation system called Starship, SpaceX hopes to make big exploration projects like Mars colonization economically achievable. The craft is made up of a massive, super-heavy first-stage booster and Starship, an upper-stage spacecraft that's 165 feet or 50 meters tall. Due to the fact that each of these components will be propelled by SpaceX's Raptor engine, they're both intended to be totally and quickly reusable. Super Heavy will carry a massive 33 Raptors, while Starship will have 6. SpaceX is aiming to change the fact that Starship hasn't yet completed any space trips. The business is getting ready for the first Starship orbital test flight, which might launch from SpaceX's South Texas site in the coming months. Sky Perfect JSAT, a Japanese satellite operator, stated on August 18th that it had chosen SpaceX's Starship rocket to put its Superbird 19 satellite into geostationary transfer orbit (GTO) as early as 2024. Sky Perfect JSAT looks to be the first client to formally agree to use Starship to launch paying customer satellites, but SpaceX or other companies have floated the idea before. According to an interview with a reporter from Space News, The mobile-friendly internet constellation startup AST SpaceMobile in March 22, the company had chosen Falcon 9 for only one of the two SpaceX launch contracts for its first operational Bluebird satellites. That executive stated that a Falcon 9 or Starship launch for the second satellite was a possibility. In a report published on August 18th, Space News revealed that Starship is a legitimate option for AST SpaceMobile's second Bluebird launch contract, which is required by the contract to execute by the end of 2024. Although Gwynne Shotwell, President and Chief Operating Officer of SpaceX, made the casual remark in May 2019, it's not yet resulted in a formal agreement. Starship may be used to launch Turkey's second domestically constructed communication satellite. NASA's Tiny Tropics Weather Satellite Constellation, which weighs only 56 kilograms or 124 pounds, will be launched by SpaceX for a price ranging from $9 million to $20 million. SpaceX already has plans to utilize Starship to launch the far larger Starlink Gen 2 satellites, and it has a contract with NASA that should result in at least two Starship moon landings, which will necessitate numerous launches to Earth orbit. SpaceX expects Starship to be able to launch up to 21 tons, about 46,000 kilograms, to geostationary transfer orbit, GTO, without refueling, according to an official payload user's manual published in 2020. Since then, the rocket's design has undergone significant alteration, increasing its maximum performance to low Earth orbit from approximately 100 tons, or 220,000 pounds, to 150 tons, or 330,000 pounds, suggesting that Starship's theoretical performance to GTO may have also improved. Although SkyPerfect JSAT withheld information regarding the anticipated weight of its new satellite, other satellites that are in the works that will use the Airbus OneSat Superbird 9 are anticipated to weigh around 3 tons, around 6,600 kilograms. Let's move to the next update for the day as SpaceX Dragon cargo ship departs the space station for its return trip to Earth. In order to prepare for a weekend splashdown, SpaceX Dragon cargo ship launched from the International Space Station on Friday, August 19th, and started its return journey to Earth. At 11:05 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, 3:05 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time, the unmanned Dragon supply ship separated from the International Space Station, and both spacecraft were traveling 259 miles above the South Pacific Ocean off the coast of Hawaii. According to NASA authorities, the spacecraft will land on August 20th, that's Saturday. Michael Ellsworth, a NASA spacecraft communicator, radioed the station crew from Mission Control in Houston saying, "Goodbye to Dragon, thank you for all the supplies and science. We're looking forward to your return to Earth. Congratulations to the team on a successful SpaceX 25 mission." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.